Hello, everybody. What's going on? This is Will here, and we're here with... Talk about redundancy and messing up words and ignoring it in the middle of a sentence. We are here with the finale of Amazing Island. That's right. And you get to see me click continue save game for the first time to see my... both my files. As you can see, this is Will Yensign, and this is William. This is a very old file because I stopped going by William at the end of grade 8, I do believe. So that's really old. This file right here is from like grade 6, I do believe. I've had that file opened for about 6 years now. 71% of the items, 100% of the events done. So if you average that out, that's about an 85.5%. I'm pretty sure, is it? I might be wrong. No, 85.5% completion overall. And that's not going back like tediously through all the minigames to see what accessories I missed. I cleaned out the shops of all the accessories and like everything. So within reason, I pretty much 100%ed the game. Not necessarily, I guess. Like if you're like hardcore, like completionist kind of person, then like no, I technically didn't. But you know, within like a casual realm of reason, I pretty much 100%ed the game. But anyway, enough about talking in the past, that's for later, and we're here at the final level, and a cutscene's about to take place, and something amazing is about to happen, something very dark and sinister and frightening. Whoa! It's like in Diddy Kong Racing, when you get, like, whatever those things you collect. Like, all the things that you need, and then Pigma's mouth opens. Or, not Pigma, jeez. Now I'm getting it confused with Star Fox. Wizpig, the mouth to, like, his lair opens or whatever. Oh, man, it's just like that. Or in Banjo-Kazooie with Gruntilda and stuff. Anyway, we can't do anything yet, because we still have to go load up a monster. So, I guess we're gonna go find a monster to use. Da-da-da-da. Go to our system menu. There's not really anything you need in form of stats for this last fight. Not really, I don't think. But, you know what? We'll go with the original guy we created. Let's go with Bony. Hell yeah, man. You're a bit dated looking, but dude, you're still pretty cool. Let's go with you. Anyway, this final battle is pretty cool. This is it right here. Like, don't think of it as like, oh, it's just another part of the game. No. This is it. This is the final encounter. It's pretty freaking awesome. It's not even a mini game. It's just called Black Evil. In the same place. Oh man, and if you noticed like right there as the camera was zooming in, you're actually playing in a cavern that's lined with a rib cage. Which is like look, just as it's spinning back around. That's pretty scary, okay? That's pretty freaky. It's a rib cage, like, with a spine. Or I guess it's just a spine, I guess. It's not really a rib cage. Whatever it is, I'm really good at biology. Anyway, so, I don't even have to read the instructions. I know what to do. The first part of this fight is actually the one you'll die at most, if you don't know what to do. You only have so many tiles to stand on, and as you can see, they give you a lot. So this isn't just another game of Eviling Volley. Oh, no. Oh, and there's the evil embodiment himself, Black Evil. So what you want to do is you want to grab the fireball, and you want to throw it back to him with the... obviously with the bar in the red or whatever, to reduce his health. And the thing you have to do, though, is you can't just hold A as soon as the button prompt comes out, because then it won't work. You'll slide back too far, and you'll die in about 2 or 3 shots. What you have to do is you have to wait for the actual... fireball to come into your hands, then you have to start holding A to reduce the stress on the hit. So this isn't just an Eviling Volley game where you can throw the fireball at him or anything. Like, you have to, like, you can't even shoot it back like a volleyball. You have to catch it and throw it back at him. That's how strong his hits are, so. I don't know. Well, you don't get to, like, directly attack him or fight him, like, engage in combat. Just, like, that kind of a, like, idea, to get that kind of an idea of how strong he is. I don't know, I just think it's a nice little comparison. And then he starts hitting that. The room starts crumbling. Shoots another fireball at you. You have to catch it. Make sure you don't die. As you can see, I only have 5 left. And here, he's going to start shooting a laser at you. And it's going to be really strong if you don't hold A. It'll push you right off the side of that. So what you want to do is you want to wait for his beam to get weak, and then just shove the fireball on his mouth, pretty much. And if you can get this far without dying, then, you know, you pretty much got it in the bag. There are a couple times where, like, if you don't tap A fast enough, you don't move up to him close enough in the amount of time, then he'll start shooting a strong laser, and you might get pushed off by surprise if you don't do it in time. But mostly this is a pretty simple one. Yeah, like, see right there, if I didn't hold A right there, I would have been killed right there. You have no idea how frustrated I got with this boss fight when I couldn't figure it out the first time through. I actually, like, screamed in the house, and my mom, like, told me to, like, shut off the game because she was getting annoyed with how frustrated I was getting. And, like that's just how frustrated I was, because I couldn't figure out that first part of it. But anyway, now we get to watch the ending cutscene and stuff. The Black Evil's just disintegrating in the lava. Yeah, like, you know, it's a game designed for kids, whatever. It's not the hardest fight, but you can understand being, like, 10 or 11 years old and not really understanding that first part fully. Because I never showed you what happens if you don't. But, it's pretty crazy. Anyway, now all these magical spirit-like particles are coming out of the lava. I'm assuming these are remaining lost souls, I assume. Or maybe people who... souls of people who don't know that Amazing Island exists? I don't know. The game doesn't exactly explain itself well enough. It's very ambiguous as to what that really could be. Or maybe it's like a portal home? Like, you know, you never really know. I like to think, yeah, like, judging by this next part here, that it's just, like, a beam that's going to, like, yeah, see, expel all evil from Amazing Island. That's what I'm thinking, you know? And there we go. And there's the whole cast and crew. All the people we saved. Chinto and whatever the other two's names were. I don't know why I can only understand. I can only remember Chinto. Another one was called, like, Dalu, I do believe. Or no, that was one of the, Mohawk Chameleons. And then you float down. Me and Boney are floating down. Aw, yeah. And then you get some frame loss because this game is horribly optimized. Oh, Will Yensign! Thank you from the bottom of my heart. This is a miracle. We are safe now, and it is all thanks to you. Notice how he's still just, like, sitting down and meditating outside? You've shown us that this power of good is something that we all bear in our hearts. I don't realize how I did any of that, but hey, whatever. You know what's another thing that I noticed? The Elder is too big to fit through both of those doors. How did he get out? Maybe he was, like, trapped in there the whole time. Oh my god, I never even thought of that. Surely, those in your world, the human world, must be aware of this as well. 1,000 years ago, when we were first born, we lived together with humans. However, as time went by, things began to grow more and more distant, until finally, that relationship was broken. Oh man, dude, look at Boney, he's going crazy, man, he's so excited. But now, seeing you here now gives me faith that humans will return to this island in time. That is what I believe. Well, that's good. That's good. Thank you again, Will Yensign! Dude, I just realized that part of, like, the... your name, like, if your name was full characters, it would get cut off near the bottom. What the heck? Oh, that is horrible. You are truly our savior. Ugh, well, that's good. Will Yensign! Jeez, so many times I have to say that. Things are going to be better from now on, and it's all thanks to you! That guy totally looks like a Deku scrub. Like, if none else did, he definitely looks the most like one. I can feel it. I'm so happy that I had the chance to get to know you. Actually, this whole LP, I never even talked to that guy once. That's the funny thing. Thank you so much. Please allow us to share our gratitude today at our celebration. Aw, hell yeah. Will Yensign, you did it. You did it. Thank you so much. I don't even have the words for how awesome you are. Yeah, okay. That's good. Hi there, Will Yensign. Congratulations, you did it. I'm so excited. It seemed like hardly any time had passed since the time when you saved me.
Oh, yeah, it's only been like, what, like 3 weeks maybe?
Come back any time. You're always welcome here. You're just the best.
Oh, well, that's cool.
Ah, Will, Yensan, mon ami.
Oh, he's supposed to have a French accent.
Ah, Will, Yensan, mon ami, merci beaucoup. My troubles are over. If people want to realize their hopes and dreams, then they need to keep on trying, despite the hardships, and never give up. Just like you've done for us, Will Yensan.
Yes, okay. I'll do my best too.
Ah, merci, Will Yensan.
Oh my god, so many people saying my name.
Like I just said, Will Yensan. Thank you, and I can't thank you enough. Will Yensan, this is all because you heard my voice and answered to my call. That's how it all began. You were always cheerful when helping us, and even when we made difficult requests, I was so worried because I thought about all the hardships you'd have to endure because of us. I felt so bad because I thought that you would have been happy, that you would have been happy to lead a happy life if I just never asked for your help.
Well, you never really got my opinion on that, but alright. Maybe I don't want to be here right now.
You've given me so much hope, strength, and courage, Will Yensan! Today is like a new beginning for us.
We'll keep on trying hard until the day when we can all live together again as one. Thank you, Will Yensan. Alright, thank you. Oh my.
Bony, what are you doing now?
That was the best dance ever. Oh my lord.
And so, this adventure comes to a close. Had it all just been nothing more than a dream from the very beginning? No one can say for sure, however.
Forever.
If you believe in your dreams, and if you open up your heart, then the Mabu will be at your side always. Perhaps tonight, when you go to sleep, you will hear their call.
Alright, so if anyone hears your call and gets sucked into Amazing Island and comes back 3 weeks later when the LP's over, someone, please tell me. Please. I would really like to know if this is true. It's gonna just haunt me forever. Anyway, then you get to see some, like... Oh yeah, you get to see some of the staff-created monsters here. Which is kind of cool, because then you get to see, like, what the monster creation tool can really do. Oh, that guy's kind of cool. Oh, so is that guy. Oh, he's cute. Okay, that thing is not cool at all. Oh, that's kind of neat. It's like a ballerina, I guess? And these are, like, these are all created in Amazing Island, so that's what I think is kind of cool. Ugh, some of them are really creepy, though. Or, like, what is it supposed to be? Oh, yeah, like, each monster was created by, like, each of these staff members, I do believe. Like, see, every time there's a name change, there's a new monster. So I would assume that these are all, like, monsters that they just created. Oh, there's the Invisible Man. That's kind of cool. Oh, or we're just gonna keep looping the same few. All right, well, that's good. Are they actually... Oh. Okay, no, we do got a different one. Or maybe that was just the same guy, who knows. And then you get to see, like, all this, like, debug footage. Not debug footage, but, like, test footage of, like, all these different events. Yeah, good job there, buddy. With the default monster for the game. Oh, that thing's creepy. Oh, so's that thing. I like bugs, but that's just weird. Oh, so's that. Oh. Ugh, god, man. That's just messed up. Teddy? What's Teddy? The University of Tokyo. Hey, for all of you who saw my Love Hina review. Haha. Tokyo U.
Teddy was a Tokyo U student.
Yeah, good. I just had to make that. Oh, GBA programmer. Did I tell you guys? No, I would have said that in the review of Amazing Island, not in the Let's Play. The Game Boy Advance functionality for this game is awesome. It is freaking amazing. I would have loved a whole game based on it. What you do is, since your monsters get, like, the sets of stats and, like, all that stuff and, like, an element and everything, you can actually transfer your monsters to a GBA, like, via the GameCube to GBA link, and you can actually play, like, a card game, like a tournament-style card game, out of monsters that have cards and, like, moves and stats made for each card to play with the card game based on, like, monsters that you create. It's the most amazing concept, and they didn't even, like, capitalize on it at all. Like, Oh, it was such a big mistake on their part. That's what I think ultimately led Amazing Island into obscurity. Like, if they really put on, like, this big, like, ad campaign saying you can transfer your monsters to playing a card game on the Game Boy Advance, I think this game would have sold amazingly well with younger audiences, but... You know, they just had to turn it into a mediocrely marketed and covered GameCube game. But anyway, I guess there's no point in just explaining or, like, whining about all that. You know, what's done is done. Test mode. Yeah, Amazing Island test mode. That's pretty much what all that was. Hisao Iguchi! Yes, executive producer. And I do believe that's it, yeah. Sega of 2004. And I actually, the first time I ever played this game was when I rented it from the video game store, Microplay, which is now closed, by the way, in case I never told you guys that. Yeah, closed, but first time I ever played, that was 2005, I rented it. Then a year later, oh, yeah, sure, save my game. And the first time I ever played it was 2005, but then a year later at Christmas, I got the game, like, for Christmas from my grandmother, so... That was kind of cool. It's pretty awesome. I didn't edit him, don't worry. But now that we've restarted this, like I promised you guys, I was going to show you something. I was going to show you what could potentially be the oldest monster to be preserved in Amazing Island. Might not be, like, you know, if, like, someone else owns the game and, like, has a monster, like, from launch year, pretty much, then you have me outbeat. But, like, I don't know, like, I'm assuming that nobody has kept their save file of Amazing Island, of, like, a game as plain as Amazing Island, like, that long. Anyway, this is what might potentially be one of the oldest monsters in Amazing Island right now. He's a dragon-type monster that I created when I was about 12, and his name is Sharky. Look at him. Look at him. Oh yeah, I got an awesome picture of him too. He's got like these like squinty eyes. Very good speed, very good mental, very good stamina. Power's a little lacking. Weight's average. But man, he is he's an amazingly well-rounded monster. Water elemental, which is something that, I don't know, I didn't really create much of during the LP. But, anyway, that's a good view to get on the pause menu, Will. Yeah, this is, man, I played through the whole game with this guy, and I just kept upgrading him. He was the first monster I ever created on this file. Like, there are a couple times where I started a file in Amazing Island in 2005 and 2006, and I played through it, but I, like, didn't really, like, beat it, and then I'd end up deleting, like, the system file and starting over. This is the monster that I played all the way through the game with one playthrough and beat the game for the first time with. So this is a very pivotal monster, and I've never deleted him off my memory card for 5 years now. Between getting my GameCube, getting my Wii, like, never deleted him, ever. And I don't ever plan to, because he's just that special to me. You know, he's just a little piece of my childhood that I can always keep. And it's wonderful. It's very nostalgic, just having Sharky out walking around behind me right now. It's quite beautiful. Anyway, after you beat the game, though, since I can show you guys on the separate file, there'll actually be another Mohawk Chameleon coming out. Hi, William. Within this cave is the lingering spirit of the Black Evil. It's not a threat to anyone, but you can still fight it. Do you want to fight again? Yeah, sure, let's fight it again. Just to show you guys, just to show Sharky in action, man. Let's get those rusty bones working again. Let's get the blood flowing, Sharky, man. Let's do this. Let's take on the Black Evil like we'd always do, man. Every time we wanted a good solid challenge. So cool. Oh, man, this is just bringing back so many memories. Anyway, since I can't show you guys a bonus episode of Sharky now, since I managed to show you guys this episode... I might do, like, a bonus episode sometime down the road of, just showing you guys, like, all the frames and stuff like that. Just to, give you guys a taste of, like, the full game. I'll show you guys, like, all the accessories that I have. I have, like, 16 pages of accessories on this file. And I'll be able to show you guys all the frames, too, so that'll be kind of cool. Oh, yeah! And we're almost done here. Well, of the first phase, at least. Aw, dude. Aw, man. Doh, I missed. Aw, Sharky, it's alright, man. Even if we don't win, that's fine. Oh, jeez, I just barely got him. Holy frig. Oh, and Black Evil's falling. And we should have this in the bag, pretty much. Oh, man, I love this music, too. It's such dramatic, cool music. Like, it really does give you that awesome feeling of, like, apocalypse, you know? Like, an end. Like, something really evil is about to happen. Oh, look, the exact same amount of tiles we had last time. Anyway, like I said, fairly easy battle, but it's just... Oh, it's just so nostalgic to get to do this with Sharky, like, seriously. And why I named him Sharky? I think it's just because of all, like, the big dorsal fins I put all over him. I'm not sure. Or no, it's because of the big, shark tooth on his... for a tail, I think I gave him. Like, everything about him is just very, like, shark and fish-like, even though he's a dragon. He's like a shark dragon. I never really thought of that until now. I guess that is why I probably gave him that name. He's a shark dragon. He's a Drago shark. That's just the way it is. Anyway, like you guys are probably thinking right now, like, what LP am I going to do after Amazing Island? Well, that's for you guys to decide, really. And as you can see, I have 90 chance stars, and since you start the game with 2 chance stars... that means I've actually created 88 monsters on this file. I've created so many different monsters, I have so many lives, and everything. It's amazing. Anyway, back on what I was trying to say. What am I going to do for the next LP? I'm letting you guys decide. I'll take, like, any request, but preferably, I have 2 games in mind that I really, I'm in the mood to do right now. One of them being a Zelda game, the other one being a Sonic game. So, like I mentioned in a bulletin, like, I know that, like, not everyone reads the bulletin, so that's why I'm mentioning it here. If you, like, want to see a Zelda game, you know, just, like, post in the comments, like, oh, Will, do Zelda, do Zelda. Or if you want to see another Sonic game, you can say, Will, do Sonic, do Sonic. Or, I don't want to say that I don't want to take a request right now. Because maybe I should just stick to what I know after doing 2 blind runs of LPs and just being back into games I know really well. But, like, you know, like, if you have a suggestion... I've already got a couple suggestions, like, just over time. People want to see Metroid Prime 2. People want to see Super Mario Galaxy. Majora's Mask is a big one right now. But, unfortunately, I'll have to give a spoiler right now. For the people who choose Zelda, I'm not doing Majora's Mask yet. It's gonna be a different one, but anyway, that pretty much rules out the obvious, so it's probably easy to guess what game it's gonna be now. But, anyway, you guys just post down in the comments, like, what you want to see, like, what you thought of the episode, and also, you know what, write down your favorite nostalgic moment, too, because I am, like, seriously, nostalgia overload right now, getting to see Sharky here. Oh, man. Yeah, look, shark tooth on his, lower back. Big, like, sailfish fins, or, like, marlin fins, sort of, fish crests on his head. He's very shark-like, very fish-like. Anyway, I hope you all have a very good life. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this LP. Actually, I think a lot of people enjoyed this one. I'm glad that, like, so many of my, viewers, like, you know, kind of appreciated this overlooked game and kind of took interest in it. I'm glad that you guys enjoyed this one. It was a humble little Let's Play, you know? Or Afterlife. If you're the records owl that I never talked to in this LP, people can kill me in the next episode. Or Sharky, if I keep pushing him. Oh! What you gonna do, man? What are you gonna do? Aw, you know what, man? Aw, jeez. Show me what you got. Aw, yeah. Look how angry he is. Look at him. Look, his fins are shaking. Hang in there, man. Aw, now look, now he's all tired. Looking good. Aw, look, now he's all happy. Aw. Jeez, Sharky is just... he's so cool. Look at him. Look at him. He's so cute and happy. Aw, he's great. Anyway, this finale is going on, like, almost 25 minutes now, so I'll just go right now. Hope you guys enjoyed it, guys. Post what you want to see next in the comments, Sonic or Zelda. And if you have time, post your favorite nostalgic memory of a video game. Or, like, I don't know, whatever. Peace.